the final liftoff of Atlantis. When NASA retired its space shuttle program in 2011, the US didn't have a way of getting to space itself. Since the government agency no longer developed its own spacecraft, it turned to private companies for a ride to the International Space Station by creating the Commercial Crew Program. Think of NASA as a customer looking for an Uber ride, and its Ubers of choice were Boeing and SpaceX. They've been developing and perfecting their infrastructure for a decade before this moment. No one thought SpaceX would be first to send NASA astronauts into orbit. This is the story of why Elon Musk's company won the race against Boeing. Boeing was the giant of the aerospace industry with a legacy stretching back more than 100 years. It seems NASA was banking on Boeing, when deciding the amount to give the companies to develop spacecraft that would fly astronauts to the ISS. NASA handed Boeing a $4.2 billion contract compared to $2.6 billion for SpaceX. Its Office of Inspector General, the oversight division for the agency, put it this way. NASA was willing to pay $90 million a seat to ride with Boeing, but only $55 million for a seat with SpaceX, assuming four astronauts for six missions. Musk pointed out it's not fair that Boeing gets so much more for the same thing. While Boeing disagreed with the OIG's report, explaining it will fly the equivalent of a fifth passenger in cargo, so the per-seat calculation would be less. With the funding, Boeing manufactured the Starliner. The Starliner had a test flight without crew to see if it was ready to fly astronauts. It was supposed to go to the International Space Station, deliver cargo, and return. Instead, there was a software problem, and that caused the engines to fire at the wrong time, and that put Starliner in the wrong orbit, so it never made it to the ISS, but it did make it home. NASA realized it had put too much trust in Boeing, which had a long history of supporting the space agency's missions. The head of NASA's Commercial Crew Program admitted, "We were, I would say, a little more used to the Boeing process." Musk once put it in a harsher way, telling the Washington Post Boeing was arrogant and complacent, and doesn't get out of bed for less than $1 billion. Boeing shot back by saying it helped NASA build the ISS before SpaceX was even born and will deliver on our commitment to America's journey to Mars. That's what we get out of bed for. While NASA didn't scrutinize Boeing enough, it paid a lot of attention to SpaceX's software development, and that's where SpaceX shined. NASA has begun the process of moving a number of astronauts assigned to Boeing's ailing Starliner spacecraft to a SpaceX Crew Dragon mission scheduled no earlier than August 2022. For sources close to Eric Berger, NASA has chosen to reassign two rookie astronauts to Crew Dragon, as hopes of a crewed Starliner launch, and thus an opportunity for them to gain hands-on spaceflight experience, in the next 6 to 12 months continue to wither. Barring surprises, the implied change of plans behind those actions means that SpaceX now appears to be scheduled to fly five operational NASA Crew Dragon missions back-to-back, before Boeing's Starliner flies a single astronaut, let alone its first operational mission with four crew aboard. In December 2019, 9 months after Crew Dragon's own uncrewed March 2019 debut, Starliner lifted off for the first time on a ULA Atlas V rocket. However, whereas Crew Dragon performed a practically flawless orbital launch, space station rendezvous, docking, departure, re-entry, and splashdown on its first try, Starliner's orbital flight test went horribly wrong as soon as it separated from Atlas V due to shoddy pre-launch testing that failed to detect several gaping holes. In Starliner's software, the spacecraft effectively lost control as soon as it was under its own power. Aside from making ground communication and control far harder, Starliner burned through most of its propellant, and pushed most of its maneuvering thrusters past their design limits in the first hour or two after launch. Due to the catastrophic software failure and lack of propellant margins, NASA unsurprisingly called off a planned space station rendezvous and docking attempt, and Boeing ultimately ordered Starliner to re-enter a few days after launch. Mere hours before re-entry, Boeing apparently detected and fixed another major software error at the last second, potentially preventing Starliner's propulsion and service module from smashing into the capsule's fragile heat shield and dooming the spacecraft to burn up during re-entry. Ultimately, it's likely that the only reason Boeing didn't suffer a total loss of vehicle during Starliner's debut spacecraft was dumb luck. Had the initial clock error been worse, Starliner could have failed to reach orbit entirely or burned through all of its propellant, resulting in an uncontrolled re-entry. Had there been no clock issue, it's hard to imagine that Boeing's software team would have attempted the panic, impromptu bug hunt that detected and fixed the service module recontact issue. Now, 22 months after Starliner's catastrophic opt, Boeing has been forced to stand down from a second self-funded orbital flight test, due to the last-second discovery of more than a dozen malfunctioning valves on the second spacecraft's service module. Aside from raising the question of how Boeing and NASA yet again failed to detect a glaring Starliner issue until the day of launch, Starliner's valve issues appear likely to cause another multi-month delay, as Boeing is forced to investigate the problem, find the root cause, and implement a fix on all impacted service modules. Regardless of who is ahead, they both benefit from contracts with NASA, because it helps fund their infrastructure that they can use elsewhere. Recently, Crew Dragon bring 4 private tourists to the Earth orbit. You can take a ride if you have $55 million to spare. And more importantly, NASA's funding has helped SpaceX develop reusable rockets. This is where SpaceX has made a name for itself. The one that launched the Crew Dragon was the Falcon 9, a partially reusable rocket because its booster lands back on Earth. But things haven't always gone smoothly. In 2015, the Falcon 9 exploded 2 minutes after liftoff during a resupply mission to the ISS. The following year, it blew up before it was supposed to launch Facebook's $200 million satellite into orbit. And landing hasn't always worked out either. But those trials appear to be in the past. SpaceX has landed the Falcon 9 booster many times in one piece, paving the way for the ultimate goal of developing a fully reusable rocket and spacecraft called Starship. This is, I think, the most inspiring thing that I've ever seen. The plan is to use Starship to send people to the moon, build a city on Mars, and for travel from one point to another on Earth. Reusability is crucial for keeping costs low in order to make space travel possible for everyone. This is the biggest difference between SpaceX and Boeing. The rocket that launched Boeing's Starliner into orbit cannot be reused. The Atlas V was developed by United Launch Alliance, or ULA, which is a joint venture between Boeing and Lockheed Martin. ULA has mentioned possibly reusing the booster engines of another rocket, the Vulcan Centaur, by catching them in the air with parachutes and a helicopter, although the company hasn't mentioned when testing will begin. Musk recently called ULA a complete waste of taxpayer money, because their rockets are not reusable. It's clear that SpaceX has a big lead over Boeing to the surprise of many industry veterans. But examined another way, it's not a surprise at all. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.